Good evening, students. In my last video, I had shared with you the capital accounts, the maintenance of the capital accounts of the partners. That is as per fixed capital method and fluctuating capital method. Children, on page number 2.24 of your TS Grewal, you have the difference between fixed capital method and fluctuating capital method. So go through that theory very properly, read it properly, and whatever doubts you have, you may clarify. Thereafter, the differences are there between capital accounts and current account. That is also there on page number 2.24. So read this page very carefully. Now, as per fixed capital method, the partners are maintaining two accounts, capital account and current account. Whereas in case of fluctuating capital method, only one account, that is the capital account, is maintained by the partners. In that aspect, I had explained you that drawings against capital versus drawings against profits. Usually, the drawings against capital reduces the capital of the owner. It reduces the capital of the owner. Capital is the main thing which is invested in business to earn profits. Okay, so it increases the profitability of the firm. But if the owner, if the partner withdraws against capital, that will decrease the capital of the owner. Okay, and in case it is drawings against profits, so these are the actual drawings, which you call it as drawings, which are to be repaid by the partners to the firm along with interest. So these two aspects I have already covered in my previous video. Now the next aspect in case of partnership accounting is remuneration payable to the partners or salary. Usually salary is payable as per the fixed amount. It is a fixed amount that, of course, if the partner is doing a good job in the business or some extra work in the business, or he is very active partner, they may agree to provide him the salary. So accordingly, salary is a fixed amount payable to him. It can be monthly, quarterly, half yearly or yearly. Thereafter, partner may even get a commission, which is an extra profits to him over and above his profits, which he gets from the business. So commission can be payable to the partners either before charging or after charging such commission. This concept, students, we have already cleared in class 11th, when manager's commission in the final accounts we had calculated. Before charging means that commission rate is not added in the amount of profits, amount of commission given to the partner. Suppose the profits of the firm are 10,000 and 10% is the commission payable to him. So this 10,000, directly 10% will be the commission payable to him. It means that on every 100 rupees profits, he is getting 10 rupees commission. So on 10,000, what will he get? Okay, then after charging means that commission is added in that profits. So in that case, 10,000 into 10 upon 110. So this 10 rupees of commission, which is added in the profit. So after charging such commission, on the basis of these two methods, commission of the partners can be calculated. Usually, commission is payable on the net profits or the divisible profits of the firm. Okay, divisible profits of the firm. So this is two aspects, that is the remuneration and commission payable to the partners. So by now I have explained you four things from this chapter. One is profit and loss appropriation account, partners capital accounts, remuneration or salary payable to them, and even the commission payable to the partners. I also explained you interest on loan, that if a partner advances interest on loan, if a partner gives loan to the firm, interest on loan will be payable to him at an agreed rate of 6% per annum. Okay. Now, next aspect we are going to start is about the interest on capitals and interest on drawings. These two are the main aspects of the chapter, so be very attentive. Children, the provisions regarding interest on capital, which are given on page number 2.30. I am explaining you that this side we will be explaining and I will be writing side by side. Just see that on page number 2.30. Now, interest on capital, 100% it is a provision, it is an appropriation out of the profits. It is an appropriation out of the profits. It means it will be provided only when there is profits. Now, there are three cases in case of interest on capital which you have to understand very carefully. And what are the provisions of the Power Partnership Act saying to that? Number one, when deed does not exist, that means there is no partnership deed, means the deed is not prepared by all the partners, naturally interest on capital will not be allowed because there is no deed. So the provision says that interest on capital will not be provided. That is the very easy to understand. When there is no deed, no mention, partners will share only the profits, and that too equally. No interest on capital will be provided to any partner. Even if they demand, it will not be provided. Number two, when the deed exists but it's silent on interest on capital as appropriation. Now this second aspect is an important aspect in which you have three main points. These are the three main points. Okay, means there is a partnership deed, partners have prepared the deed, but it is silent on the point that whether interest on capital should be treated as a charge or an appropriation. 99.9% it is an appropriation, but the deed that does not speaks about it, the deed does not says that it is a charge or an appropriation. What is to be done? The partners have to solve the problems. Now the provisions of the act will apply to it, that there is a deed but it is silent on the point that whether interest on capital should be an appropriation or no. Only that much. Naturally, it has to be treated as an appropriation. Okay, so there are three concepts. That deed is there, but the firm has loss. Firm has loss. No interest will be provided. No interest on capital will be provided. Okay, if there is a loss. Though there is deed, but it is silent. Number two, profits are more means profit zyada hai interest on capital se. Interest on capital dena hai sirf 10,000, profits hai 20,000. Fine, you can give. So profits are more than the interest on capital, then interest on capital will be allowed. Okay, it will be given fully to the partners. And the third case, profits are less than the interest on drawings. Profits are less. We interest dena tha 10,000, lekin profits hai sirf 8,000. 8,000. Kaise denge? You cannot give 10,000 interest on capital to the partners. So in this case, if profits are less than the interest on capital, then profits will be divided in interest on capital ratio. Interest on capital ratio. This we have to understand when we will solve the problems. At that time, I'll make you explain it again. But see this. The second concept has three options, three alternatives. The firm may have loss. The firm may have more profits than the interest to be allowed. And the firm may have less profits than the interest. Naturally, under these circumstances, if there is a loss, no interest will be provided. Profits are more, interest will be allowed. If profits are less, profits will be divided in the interest on capital ratio. Okay, and the last thing, the K stands for when deed provides for interest on capital as a charge. मतलब partnership deed में लिखा है कि interest on capital हर हाल में देंगे, चाहे profit हो चाहे loss हो, right? Then naturally the provision speaks that interest on capital will be allowed even in case of loss. Okay, even in case of loss. So see this interest on capital, the cases, there are three cases, and the provisions of the Partnership Act speaks that interest on capital is 99.9%, it is an appropriation out of the profits. Only in 0.1% case, if it is provided in the deed that it will be treated as a charge, then only it can be treated as a charge and interest on capital will be allowed even if the firm incurs loss. Okay? Okay students, now I will be explaining you the interest on the concepts of interest on drawings, which I will be continuing in my next video. Thank you.